Two dice are rolled. How many points are in the sample space? Well, we have 6 outcomes for die number 1. We have 6 outcomes for die number 2. In our video on tree diagrams, which I will hopefully be popping up a link to right now, we had a counting principle that said the total number of values in our sample space is going to be those two numbers multiplied together. That gives us 36 total values in our sample space. Now this is going to be a little bit tedious, but I'm going to write out the whole sample space for you right now so that we can use it in these next two problems. All right, there it is, and it is confirmed there are 36 points in the sample space. So what is the probability that you roll a double? Well, how many rolls in the sample space are doubles? I'm seeing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 doubles in that sample space out of a total of 36 rolls. That is our probability. It does reduce to 1/6. If you wanted to type it into your calculator, you would get 0.1666 repeating. The next problem asks, what is the probability that you roll a sum of 4? Okay, so I'm going to circle all of the dice rolls that sum to 4. It's cool they line up in a diagonal like that. It looks like there are just 3 ways to roll a sum of 4 out of 36 total rolls. That does reduce to 1/12, and I'll just leave it as 1/12. All right, and the last question asks, what is the probability that you roll a sum that is not 4? There are a couple ways to do this, but the key word here is not. If we want to use our probability formulas, this formula comes from the first video on probabilities, which I will hopefully be popping up a link to right now. But the probability of not something happening is 1 minus the probability of that thing happening. Oh, so I probably should have been using good notation up here. In part B, we found the probability of a double. In part C, we found the probability of rolling a sum of 4. So anyway, back to this problem. The probability of not rolling a sum of 4 should be 1 minus the probability of rolling a sum of 4. We already calculated that probability as 1/12. If you like the fractions, this answer comes out to be 11/12, or as a decimal, 0.9166 repeating. I think 11/12 is a pretty nice answer. But there was another way that you could do this problem. You could go up to your sample space and count up all of the ways that you could roll something that doesn't give you a sum of 4. So if you count all of those up, you would get 33 total out of 36, and that is a fraction that ends up reducing to 11/12 anyway. So sometimes using the formula can save you a little bit of time. And all right, now that I've totally destroyed my sample space, I think we can move on to the next problem. I'll see you there.